Good evening. Thank you to each and every one of you for coming this evening. Before stepping into the chambers this evening and presenting my explanation, I have already been tried, convicted, and sentenced to a recall election. In the time allotted for my explanation, I will present an event timeline, an expert on all things Facebook, from the local university, to explain the misinformation presented against me. A couple of character witnesses will make a brief statement. Rest assured, I intend to stay the course and resist resignation of my duly elected position on the Plano City Council. Some additional information regarding my military history so nobody gets confused. I joined the Naval Air Reserve when I was 20 years old. It was 1964. I was in college, and the Vietnam War was raging on. I knew I had an obligation to do my part. So schooling was put on hold, and I enlisted. I was honorably discharged in 1970, and I am a member of the American Legion Post and Corps today. To give you a rundown of what has led to where we are today, it all began the evening of Tuesday, February 13th, as I was looking through my private Facebook account, what I thought was a mime or a picture turned out to be what was on separation of church and state in schools was actually a video attached to that picture. My thoughts of the picture had nothing to do with any particular religion. The role in religion of schools has been an ongoing debate for many years. In less than 12 hours, a press conference was organized. And about 4 hours later, at that press conference, my resignation was being called for. The day of the press conference, Wednesday, February the 14th, I had two doctor's appointments. The reason I didn't stand up is because I don't have a leg. And the medical tests were being performed. In between these medical tests, I attended my Bible study. During this time, my phone was in my wife's purse, turned off, because they had no use for it in the medicals or the Bible study. A special session was then called on Sunday, February 18th. I, as well as two other council people, were very surprised and blindsided at what was shared in the way of images that were found on my account site, my Facebook site. The images that I didn't recall having seen. You will hear from Cindy Marcus, okay? She is a social media professional that took my Facebook site and looked at it thoroughly. In a few moments, you will hear her explanation of the behind-the-scenes world of your individual Facebook accounts. During the last 3 years, I have consistently followed the promises I made during my election campaign. Fiscal responsibility, we've had two tax reductions. Expansion of the senior city finally began after it was approved on a bond election in 2009. There is a rezoning in one area, which is Mustang Square, which the residents around there were quite upset because the apartments, they adjusted that in the zoning commission to become townhouses. The other thing we've been doing lately is monitoring an additional 9,000 units of high density housing apartments within our city. I have enjoyed working with Plano Multicultural Outreach Program for the last 3 years, which encourages unity in our city. I would like to continue to support the unifying, the density, unification of the density, and not dividing cultures. I have supported other groups, such as Plano Helpers, Love Where You Live, and an organization where we're doing microfinancing in Cameroon, Africa. I believe I have made and kept promises to the citizens of the city of Plano. I'm standing up for everyone and not against anyone. Thank you for your time and your attention.